ocean. We all start in the streams. We're all carried along by the river of dreams. In the middle of the night.
So you like gospel?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, that sounded really good.
Thanks.
It's great to have you here.
Yeah,
it really is. We've never actually met you before, so it's good.
And you've never met us.
And you've never met us. No. But are you in this country often, or is this a rarity?
I'm here once every couple of years. And when we've been touring in England since the mid-70s, so every time we do a tour, we're here. And when I come through on a press junket, I'm here.
You're here to promote the album, aren't you, basically? Yeah. What's it called?
It's Greatest Hits Volume 3.
Right. But isn't there one new track on it?
There's three new songs, but I didn't write them. They're by three different great songwriters.
Yeah.
Carole King, Bob Dylan, and Leonard Cohen.
Oh, fab. Yeah. Are you guys sort of personal friends at that level? Do you ring each other up? Do you sort of hang out?
I know other songwriters who I'm friends with, people like Don Henley.
From the Eagles.
I'm friends with Elton, obviously.
Elton John.
Yeah, a couple of people.
Sure. And is that because you kind of meet on the circuit? I mean, you met Elton on a road in Amsterdam or something, didn't you?
We met in Amsterdam. We were both doing gigs, and it turned out we were mutual fans of each other.
Right.
And, when you read in the press, they'd make it a rivalry, but we never had anything like that.
Well, that's because in America, I mean, it's a smallish tag that you carry around, which is that you're kind of America's Elton.
That's when I started out. That's what I was tagged with.
Yeah.
But,
We
understood each other. It was okay.
You started off as a classical. You trained as a classical pianist, didn't you?
Yeah.
Was that your idea or your parents' idea?
No, it was my mom's idea. I didn't want to play the piano. I wanted to play baseball.
Yeah.
She dragged me down the street.
And did she force you to practice?
Yeah. I was about 4 years old. She said, and I was banging the piano. She said, "Look, if you're going to bang, bang it right." And my dad was a pianist. He was trained in Germany, so it's in the family.
So how far did you get on the classical road?
I took classical piano for 11 years. I was pretty good. By the time I was about 12 or 13, I was pretty good. I could sight read. I was doing concerts and recitals.
Mm-hmm.
But I wasn't having as much fun as the guys who were playing the rock and roll.
Yeah.
So I got into a band, and then I started having fun and meeting girls, and things got real interesting.
And what did you, when you got into a band, were you playing keyboards? Is that how it started?
You know what? Originally, we'd have to take a microphone, the mic that we sang with, and stick it in the back of an upright piano. There really were no good keyboards until there was an English band that came over, the Dave Clark Five. It's about the mid
60s.
Yeah. And they had a Vox Continental.
A Vox Continental, wasn't it?
Vox Continental organ, and finally keyboard players had something they could play, and the technology got better and better. But originally there wasn't that much for us to work with.
It's funny you should say that, because thinking about it, I think, and you think of bands like the Animals, it was Brit bands that pioneered keyboards in pop, wasn't it?
I don't know, is it?
A lot of the technology came from over here. We saw instruments that we didn't have in the States. We said, I want one of those.
Yeah. Mm.
Where do we get one of those? And it took a while for us to get them.
Just on a completely sort of non-musical level, how are the Americans taking being completely hammered by our speed team in the desert? You know what I'm talking about?
I haven't kept up with it.
Neither have I.
Neither the Americans, it seems. I'm just teasing you.
He's just obsessive about it.
No, it's brilliant. We've broken the sound barrier in a car. All right, anyway.
in Nevada.
In Black Rock Desert.
You've going back to your classical thing, you've actually got a scholarship that you award now, haven't you?
Mm.
I have a scholarship for a keyboard pianist, actually, up in Tanglewood, which is our classical music school.
Right. But that is for classical playing, it's not for rock?
It's classical piano.
So you've still retained a very strong interest in it. And you've got a lovely little daughter, who we have got a picture of, who's a very talented pianist herself.
She's doing okay. She's been taking lessons for a couple of years.
Oh,
look at that. She's cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's got a good ear. She's left-handed, so she's got a head start on the piano. If you're left-handed, it helps being a pianist.
Why?
Because all the interesting melodic stuff is played by the right hand.
Yes.
The left hand usually has to play like in a boring accompanist stuff.
Bottom chords.
A lot of times, for people who are right-handed, the left hand kind of suffers because it's harder to pick it out and figure out what to play.
Right.
But if you're left-handed, it comes natural. And the right hand will follow because that's where the melody is.
So just thinking about that, she could play, this isn't classical, Boogie Woogie really well. She could get that role, couldn't she?
Yeah, she's got a good left hand. If you got a good left hand, you'll be okay as a pianist.
Are you left-handed?
No, I'm right-handed.
Still,
you can tell my left hand, I got a bandage on it.
How'd you get that?
It's actually from an old motorcycle accident, and sometimes Yeah. If I bang, then there's no bone in this thumb, so I've got to watch it. I've got to be careful.
Oh, I see.
Really?
Yeah.
God. Well, look, listen, we must show Hey Girl, because this is from the album, but it's also you're releasing it as a single.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, well, here we go.
Hey girl, now don't put me on. What's gonna happen to me when you're gone? Can I go on?
Is it?
It's Felix from the Rascals.
The keyboard player in this, Felix Cavalier from the Rascals.
who wrote that?
That was written by Carole King and Jerry Goffin. Carole King is one of the great, great songwriters, predating the Beatles. And I know that McCartney and Lennon were listening to King and Goffin.
Yeah.
Songs and wanted to be a songwriting team like Carole King and Jerry Goffin.
Really?
Yeah. It was a hit in 1963.
Yes, I thought it was. Yeah.
When did you realize that, in addition to your piano talents, you could sing? You'd got such a strong voice.
I was in chorus in school, and the chorus teacher used to have me singing the solos in front of the chorus until I would get in trouble, and then she would throw me out. But then she would always have to bring me back into the chorus. So I figured I must be okay, because I really would get in deep trouble and she would always have to put me back in the chorus.
Right.
Yeah.
So when I joined a band, they wanted me to be the singer, which I thought was kind of funny. I didn't really think of myself as a singer.
Interesting.
That's extraordinary.
Yeah.
It's nice to come through.
Well, listen, good luck with it. So the album's called again?
Greatest Hits
Volume 3, want to get that right. And the single that's coming off it is Hey Girl.
Yep.
Great. Okay, well, good luck with it.
Thanks for being here.
It's good to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Okay.
Any instrument that's well played.